So hello and welcome to my live coding session where I implement my application, which is Bucket Manager, a useful JavaFX application for managing XML files, which consists of satellite channels information. So I took some time off camera. Usually I record the whole process, but. In this case, I made an exception. I'm running my Eclipse on Java version 9. And yeah. So, what is all about? Today, I want to show you some progress of my project. So, basically, what I have done, I created a controller. I actually not created, extended further the controller for services list, and then I have written a model class, which was some sort of strange for me because I have already done such work, but it was necessary to use additional class to then later to load this class into the UI. Because UI and JavaFX especially for the tree view table, have some sort of a complex access routine. And I was not able to cast my model to make sure that I'm passing all the values as I wanted. And it was quite a bit of challenge. It took me a while to get through this whole problem. And let me actually show you first my view. Now all of my fxmls finally are in the source main resources as is supposed to be, and here it is my main view form, which was created through the Scene Builder actually was started on another screen. So basically I'm done with the populating of the left side of my application. Now I have kind of more deep understanding on how to access the tree table view. I hope that I would not spend much time on the right side, because right side need to be done too at some point of time, but not today. And let me just quickly go over the tests which I have written. And in this case, what I have in my situation, the tests kind of rudimentary, but still I am trying to do the tests. And testing UI not actually a simple task. It's actually sometimes difficult task because it's not always stable. So I'm using a framework Java TestFX, which is still in development. And actually I'm using, let me just quickly watch it, look it up, my pom.xml. I'm actually using TestFX. And this should be TestFX 4.0.15 alpha. So do not expect too much, but still, here is my view test. Basically, I input the data through the user actions, like user type the stuff in, and then I expect to get some sort of validation. This is one of the last tests which I have written. Just check that all of my columns are not null. It means like I have populated rows in the columns. But test is kind of trivial. But a lot of work was actually done with services Yeah, I know. I have a lot of stuff here. So, controllers, main menu, services list controller. This is my controller, and yeah, I'm building my set of site services. This is actually where I'm getting the first access to my, after the reading of the file, XML file. Then I create root tree item, and then I set up additional roots, like additional elements to this tree item. And after that, I'm making sure that it can be actually displayed in the application. And the main problem was like get hold of all this, all necessary values. So you saw previously in my recording session that I use my own model classes, but in this case I was like technology pushed me to the limit, and I was like not getting to the point where I supposed to be. So I was so I actually created another class, which is UI model service list. This is of course was created with the help of TDD. And look at this property values. These property values are necessary to be used in combination with JavaFX. So if you don't have such class with such data type, I don't know how will you do that. Maybe some sort of ugly injection, and maybe some sort of a trickery, additional magic stuff. But I'm trying actually to make my project simple as possible. I do not wish to have, some sort super Java tricks which can make maybe 5 or 6 or 1 hour my life easier, but in the future it would just be ugly to read and difficult to maintain. So I'm trying to do the simple stuff first, and the really hard stuff should be done at least at last point. Always try to make simple stuff. So this class, I access it through my service list controller, and I using it when I want to, first of all, I of course need to read the XML. Here it is, the code, and I'm reading the XML file, creating Java objects, and the whole result is a list of satellite with services variable. But then I take all values and put them to my another model class. After that, after my insertion is done, I'm clearing the not needed services variable. I'm cleaning this variable through clear method. And I plan in future not to do that, but for my current project state I'm doing, because I do not want to forget that I need to clean memory if I don't use that memory. So it's pretty important. And after I done that, after I populated my UI, I actually here cleaning the memory of another model class. So in any case, it is working. So now with further development, I just need to show you my tests. Let me just do it like that, and I can now actually execute all of my tests which I have written. So now I have like execution of full of my test suite, and it's compiling, executing tests, and now it should start running all of the tests. Now it starts running all of unit tests and UI tests. basically it's running in the automotive mode. I don't do anything, it's automatically running. So yeah, tree table view in my opinion was over engineered. I mean, it should be so complicated to use it, but I need to get even more familiar, because I'm not a UI guy. I'm actually backend guy. Yeah, logic can be done, need to be done in the UI frontend, but I have my specialty in the backend most times. So don't think that it is like, yeah. And you see clearly it's running and all tests passing through. But testing UI some sort of a challenging. I mean, I'm using a alpha test framework for the JavaFX. So some quirks I expect to arrive, to appear, but I'm not spending my time with debugging. I'm spending my time with writing unit tests and working with the real code. So, and it was pretty interesting. I mean, today I was like running my test and I was quite puzzled at first, but then I discovered that I really need to check null pointer exception in my new model class, and this was actually not bad, because after that I catched all of the exceptions and nothing happens badly with my application. So now it's stable enough. I mean, it's like in a further development, it's not completely done, because I need to be able to write right side of the screen. I mean, to be able to load my screen with data. And you see clearly now I'm getting population of my values. Now it's actually cool. Okay. It's works like that, and after that it just getting through. So, but basically I want to repeat, it was kind of for me frightening to discover that my model was not quite suitable for rendering in JavaFX. I mean, I expected more support for JavaFX. Maybe I have not so much experience with JavaFX rendering stuff. But anyway, it took me a while to get through the quirks. I think I spent today like 2 or 3 hours in real work figuring out the stuff. Anytime I try to do the test first, and I always try to write my test thinking about the code, it gets at some point pretty hard to get through, because so many stuff can go wrong and you cannot see any additional paths. So now the result, I have 193 test runs, and you saw, and almost completely 0 errors and 10 tests skipped, optional tests. But anyway, if I want to clearly show you that, let me just clear the output. For example, let's just do some manual tests to see the data and to see how it looks like actually. So I can start my application like that. My application is started. And after that, I just need to, where is my test? Here's my test. I need to take my data, test data. I know it's have a dependency on Windows. dependency on Windows, and now just run open XML file. I input real file into it, then it shows me that I loaded buckets, then I load my satellites XML, and I see that satellites XML are actually loaded too. And then I need to load my services. I load my services, and here you go. And I did not experience any error during the whole process. So now I have this data. This data is kind of, it's actually like a queue. It's kind of ordered. Actually, JavaFX has stuff like sorting, but this is like out of the box. I did not written any code to do that. It was quite funny discovery for me to discover that actually have some ordering features which I did not written. It was like out of the box. And I have here alphabetically sort by satellites. Basically, I see it's have some additional potential, but I did not implement it its features. I will probably later implement it when it needs to be done, because at my current point of view, I managed to get the data, and I need to be able to then populate my right side of my application, and then I just need to make some assurance that I have like 50% here. I need to be make sure that this side takes like half of the screen, but this is kind of minor issues. Anyway, I am able to load the data, and how I will do further access of this information. Well, what the user see, basically the stuff which I load into memory, it's now at the current state of my project is always garbage collected. I mean, not garbage collected, better to say cleaned. Cleaned before I populate the UI. And my idea, I will basically write once into the memory. The user will access the information, and then it will be looked up into memory. So I won't write, actually I won't read many times one and the same information from the hard drive. Make no sense in my opinion. What I will do, I stay with the clean of my UI. So what I mean by that, always when the data is loaded in my application, the temporal memory, it's like variable lists, list of the elements will be cleaned, and the first variable where I store all information which I have loaded from services list, this is all of my objects which I have loaded, this will be further stored, and actually user will actually, it will invoke, it will click on some of the channel two times, and maybe screen appear in the future with further additional properties. But this is kind of for the future. Currently, it's going to be probably in the next build like following that. I take here the information populated. It will be many favorites, and next step will be like populating the right side with data from the favorites file, and after that user can start interaction, so it can pick up I don't think that I have only one selection. Maybe I should activate multiple selection in the future. But first, the user will point to the file. Then it click like add to favorite list, and it will be added to the opened tab. So I have here a tab in which I have this tree view. I hope it's tree view, not tree table view. Table view. So, and here it will be basically possible then to rename it in the favorites, to delete in channel, to mark for copy, because if a user wish to have a copy into another favorite, why not? And yeah, so basically some stuff need to be done, a lot of work for the future, but I will do it like in my spare time. As I said earlier, my project I doing only in my spare time when I have time, because I have currently a lot of projects, a lot of interesting JavaFX projects, JavaScript projects, and Spring Boot projects, cloud-based applications, because cloud is like in hyped, in trend. But anyway, I'm pretty happy with the current state of my app and how project is developing. And I will do it further like I have done previously, writing test, passing test, discover new stuff, and yeah, I do not hope that I need to write additional models for my UI. Maybe it will not be so necessary, but still, pretty future will be like looking up the channel and then in the UI select the channel which user input, where he done some input. And yeah, I think you can imagine a lot of stuff, but I will probably do the base stuff, like add channel to the favorite category, and after doing that, I just can work on additional features which my application have. But I will do it like in reasonable amount of time, without any pretty big huge steps. But anyway. If you like my project, you can actually support it. I always forget to mention that, but I will mention that. You can donate via BTC, via PayPal. I have many, many different options here. If you cannot donate, it's okay. It's not my main project. But if you like what you see, you can subscribe, you can add to your favorite list, and I will be happy to see you again soon. So thank you for your time and have a nice time. Bye bye. Thank you.